family, they want to say thank you for being here and supporting them during this time. They love you for the flowers, the food, and more than anything else, for all the prayers and telephone calls. And just being here present means a lot to them, and continue to remember them in your prayers. I realize today as we come here and with Miss Janie that Brother Carol and Ronald, I can be honest with you, it's not easy. It's not easy when Mom is not here anymore. You go see her or pick up the phone and make a telephone call to her, see what's going on. That it doesn't make life easy when someone you love is no longer here, but also to realize that today is just not a day of saying that she's gone. It's a day to remember the times that she spent together. And Doug, realize that being around Miss Janie, I found out real quick that you weren't a son-in-law, you just like one of the others, you know. I mean, that's just the way it was, like a son, all the family. And you know, when I thought of Miss Janie, when I knew that we've been praying for her, and you know, when it comes to a point in your life that all that you do, all that you say, all the prayers, and nothing changes as far as health-wise, that's like one pastor told, or preacher said years and years ago, he says, you know, we pray for the healing of God, for there to be a healing in someone that we love or someone that's going through something. And says, sometimes, you know, we question why God didn't do his work. But then he says, for the child of God, Glenn, he did. Because he did do the healing, a new body, a new life. And you know, when I think of Miss Janie, I have to be honest with you, I can still see that smile. It, when the times are getting together, I used to say when the first one we got invited to, you know, when she was this year, of course we know there's a celebration going on in heaven, probably a lot of talking going on, normal, but I realized that the first one we got, our kids were small, you know, we got invited to the, where it was a birthday or where it was just a get together, you know, barbecue a pig and all, and I remember the first one I told Sandy, I never got the words, I says, say, a family, this is the clan. Look at the clan that showed up. They come from the hills, they come from the valleys. I mean, where'd they all come from? I was, that's where I got to know all the family, I says. And I, then, you know, it became a regular thing. I could still see in that smile, everybody welcoming us, and Miss Janie coming up and saying, good to have you, and introducing herself. And I remember one after each other, every year, there'd be some special event, you know, and having a barbecue, doing something, and all the stuff was going on. And I said, when you got the family together, the rest are together, they won't never look at nobody else, but you find it to do the best you could, find a parking place. But you know, those were good memories. You know, so many times that when someone is going through something, when a family is faced with sickness or situations of life, whatever it may be, it's sort of to look on the tough side, in which it is tough. And it's all to be remembering what someone that you love went through in the last days or last months, last years on this earth. But yet it's a time also to remember that today is not just a time of remembering. But for the child of God, an individual that accepted Jesus Christ, it's a day of celebrating. And to know that I can't stand here before you without saying celebration in her life. Because there's no doubt in my mind where she's at when I received the call that Mom was gone. I knew where she was going. She was going to be with the Lord. And you know, so many times we take it for granted in life that not realizing that our loved ones that know Jesus Christ or anyone, that it doesn't end here. It will not end at the service at the cemetery. Her life really began the other day when she left this world. That's when life begins. We say, well, God's given us life here. Yes, but it's a temporary here. But life eternal is forever. Either you're with Christ or without Him. I used to say, saw something one time and says, you know, are you with me or are you not with me? I found out I want to be with him, not without him, because the final results without him is a place called hell, and I don't want to go there. Someone says, Glenn, I see enough of that stuff on the face of the earth. I say, well, get it together then. I want to be in heaven when it comes. I want to be when I leave this world. And there's no doubt in Miss Jane's life, 87 years that God allowed her to be on this earth. And to know that all the things that she saw in life. But remember, 87 years when you children came along, she brought you into this world. Look at the years that you've had time to be with her as family, as friends, times that you spent together. Like I say, whether it was being there in the presence or hearing her voice over the phone. No, we won't hear that voice over the phone anymore. We won't have the privilege of having the get-togethers and she not being there. Times change, but it's one thing that doesn't change, that is God. Jehovah doesn't change. Jesus says the same yesterday, today, and forever. That means that's eternity. From the beginning, right on, from eternity not to the end, eternity to eternity. And I say, family, that as you cherish the good memories of growing up, being together, even these last years, to realize that there'll be days, and I'm not going to tell you, it won't be days, that you'll begin to think about this, Miss Janie, and tears will come to your eyes. But I'm going to tell you, there's going to be things that you're going to think and reminisce over her life. There'll be a smile. Might it be a time of laughter or something, you know, because when you got around the breakfast, you never know what was going to come out. You never know what someone was going to say. And I mean, that's just the way it was. So you just took it with a grain of salt and went on to be a part of the family. But I have to admit, Miss Janie, as well as others, made me a part. Me and Sandy, my family. They made us a part of their family. That's the kind of lady she was. That was the kind of woman she was. That you were not a stranger. When she got to know you, and it didn't take long, she found out real quick who you were. And that was her life. And you know, the family can tell you that. Ones that, friends that knew her and been around her can tell you that. But you know, I look at not only the good memories, but also looked at where she believed. She was supportive of our church. The years she worked, and I didn't ever hold it against her when I found out that she was working at Duke University. I said, well, and I'll never forget one conversation. You know how sometimes sports will come up, you know, and in our church you got Tar Heels and Duke and Campbells, and you got some state fans like myself. You know, and I mean, that's just the way life is. But I didn't hold that against her, and I, on one occasion, you know, joking and carrying on, and I mistake mine, got fortunate and beat Duke or something, you know. But anyhow, that I told her one time, I said, you know, when I found out, you know, that's where she worked, I said, well, I really didn't hold this against you. She said, look, I just work there. And I didn't say nothing else. That, you know, that took care of that. I just worked there. So, I mean, but you know, remember the good times. That's the most precious in this whole life, no matter of suffering, no matter what you go through. But to remember, too, that life begins if we know Jesus Christ as our Savior. You know, she knew. And when she supported her church, was there when she was able. And when she came down to Johnston County, guess where? She'd come by, see her on Sunday morning, still see that smile. And coming out the door, I said, Miss Jane, so glad you could be here. Yeah, just so glad I could be here. But even when she came here, she wanted to be in church with you. And you know, the church doesn't get us to heaven. It's what's in our heart, who we are. Because we are the church, the living of God, that know Jesus Christ their Savior. And you know, Jesus gave us that hope. Because we live in a visible world. You know, I'll be honest with you, and I say it, where the world is going today, and has been, but I mean really now, thank God she's home. Amen. Because, you know, the hardest is when you hear one see of her life. Glenn, I never thought I'd live to see it be like it is today. The anger, the anguish, the separation, the lies. And I said, yes, but guess what? God's got a plan. As long as we're in His plan, no matter what happens to us in this life, we know where we're going. And you know, Jesus made that very clear in chapter 14 of the book of John. Because when He said this, and I begin to look back at about in the Word of God in the Old Testament, and because the Old Testament are together. They're not two separate books. They're together. It's one word. And I begin to look at, you know, we talk about John 14, but you know, to know that she knew John 14 because she knew Jesus Christ. And you know, when He said, let not your heart be troubled. If you believe in God, believe also in Me. And here is the most important, because when Jesus was saying this, the disciples didn't understand. There was a lot of disciples didn't understand, the apostles. They didn't understand what He was talking about. That, you know, when He says that, believe also in Me, in My Father's house are many mansions, you know. They thought Christ was going to be with them forever right here on this earth. They weren't anticipating Him facing the cross giving his life on the cross that we might be free, that we would have freedom through Jesus Christ no matter who we are, what country we are from. We're all one in his eyes. But they eventually saw that later when he was also, when he left this world in a way, what he went through. That he said, in my Father's house are many mansions. That tells me that God's got a plan. And then he says, if it were not so, in other words, Jesus said, I'm not telling you the non-truth. I'm not being mistruthful. Because he says, listen, I go to prepare a place for you. In other words, he was telling them of his upcoming death on the cross and his resurrection. And that he was going to die, that Miss Janie could have a home to be with him. That she wouldn't be left here, that her soul wouldn't be with him. And God, the body will be your resurrection, but the soul was going to be with Christ, the living. And then he says, listen, I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go to prepare a place for you, I will, this is what I like, of this verse, is that he says, I'm coming back. Hallelujah. He's coming back, people. He's coming back. But Miss Janie said, well, she's going to go. She's going to be with him. But he says, I am coming back. And I will come again, receiving to myself. That means he says, there's going to be a rapture. There's going to be a call up that I'm going to, and the dead in Christ. Miss Janie's not going to be in the ground. The body's there. The soul's with God. Where reality is. But that body's going to rise from the grave. But you know what? The most important, are we ready to go? Are we going to be able to see her again? I want to see her. I want to see Jesus, first of all. Then I want to see the loved ones that have gone on. It's Miss Eula, Miss Janie, other ones, my family that I knew that went to be with God. And you see, through this, he says, I will come again and receive you to myself, that where I am, and where I go, you know, and the way, you know. And you know, Thomas even had a question from one of his disciples. He says, you know, Jesus, what are you really talking about here? What you mean? We're going to be with you. Where are you going? The most important, Jesus knew what he was doing. Yes, did he want to go the way he had? No. He was the Son of God. God and man incarnated in the flesh, the Spirit of God. God through him, that he might die on the cross, that Miss Janie could have hope. And when she accepted Christ in her heart, she received that hope that she was going to be with him. Well, and you know, that's where it's at. And even when he told Thomas, he says, Thomas, I, not all these false gods of the world, not all these religions of the world, I am the way, the truth, and the life. She met the way, the truth, and the life in her relationship with Jesus Christ. And the most important that I want to leave with you today, because I thank God I had the privilege to meet her through the rest of her family. But you know, I thank Jesus Christ that she knew him as her Savior. Because you see, we don't have the promise of not tomorrow, of the next second, that we could be taken from this world. And the most important, where are we going? A lot of stuff is going on in the world that, you know what? I look at this book. Some says, what is happening in the world? Where's it coming? It's right here in the book from Genesis to Revelation. He tells it. And if you don't hear it, you need to get to where it's being taught and preached and lived, because that's important. This is the truth. This is God's word to all of us. She accepted God's word. Meaning today, hear it. But it's one thing to hear it. See, Thomas heard what Jesus was saying, but he was not accepting it. He was not taking it in here until Jesus said, Thomas, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one will come into the Father but by and through me. We have to go by Jesus Christ. And that simple is, Jesus, I give my life to you. I accept you as my Savior. And I want to see my loved ones again. And I know we all have loved ones that departed. Does it make it easy? No. Some days it'll be tough. Because you know why? You just can't see them here anymore. To me, that's the hardest part of separation from someone you love. Is I can't see them in the flesh. And And I sort of get that spirit of Thomas. And then all of a sudden, the Holy Spirit says, wait a minute here. What did Jesus say to you? What is he telling you? That he's the way, the truth, the life. That you can is spirit's life eternal. You can see Jesus. You can see your loved ones again. But you've got to come to the same Jesus by and through the blood with your sins washed away that you can see your loved ones again. Family, that's what it's about. I want to see Miss Janie. I want to see all those that are gone. But we must know this assurance. That's a promise. Jesus didn't just say that. It was a promise. Just as the covenant of God was a promise to Abraham of the nation of Israel. And God has never broke a covenant, and Jesus never broke a promise. And he never will, and God never will. Today, when we walk from here, the most important, do you have that same relationship that she had? You say, Glenn, why can you say this? Because I knew her. You knew her. There was no doubt in your mind that where she was going, she drew her last breath on this earth. And you know, even through suffering and pain, that as loved ones that we've experienced through love of other loved ones, the hardest thing is to turn them loose. But then when we realize that where they're going, we realize, Lord, we've got to turn loose. We still love them. And you always love them till you see them again. Because we know that they're leaving this world of suffering and pain. You know, for a child of God, it's not death. It's life. They know they see all the crazy stuff in this country. They know that they're with Jesus. And you know what? If he takes me, I know I'm going to come back to him. Because he's going to straighten all that, folks. She tried. And once her agent tried to straighten me, and still are. Because I got some of them still telling me what to do. They said, we're a little older than you are. And so I found out, just listen. Because really, they're being honest with you. You see, 87 years old was a lot of years of knowledge, a lot of years of seeing it, and a lot of years of seeing the practical, and a lot of years of living it. But yet to know the final was not the final here. It's just the beginning. Hold on to Jesus. If you don't know him as your Savior, because you say, you don't preach anyone into hell or hell. The person is responsible for their own life. Not I. You're responsible for their life. I'm responsible for bringing the truth. I'll be held accountable if I don't bring the truth. Whether it hurts or what. The truth. But yet, we all responsible. She had the responsibility of who she was going to serve. And in her life, she chose Jesus. We each have that responsibility. Do we want Jesus in our life and to lead us in the right way, or do we want the other? And if you go the other way, be careful, because you could lose for eternity, but you can gain for eternity through Jesus. Hold on to the precious memories, and hold on that you will see her again, family. You know Christ. You live for him. You're going to see her. And it's a temporary separation. It's not forever. If you live to be 100, 200 years on this earth, that's nothing compared to eternity. I want to be in eternity with God. Heavenly Father, I thank you, Lord, for your Holy Spirit in this place. Because, Lord, I know Miss Janie, Lord, and I know where she's at. And, Lord Jesus, I know this family. A family that of love, a family that's been friends and are still friends to my family. And Lord, I thank you for the friendship of the years of Miss Janie, Lord. And the times of being together, whether at church or at a cookout. But God, I thank you most of all that she knew you as her Savior. And she knew that when she took the last breath on this earth, that she was going to open up her eyes in heaven and be there with you and see you. See you, Lord Jesus. And then the ones around her. And Lord, I pray, Father, that even though we know where she's at, I pray for the family that you comfort them for the days ahead. Because yes, there will be days that there are going to be some tears. But Lord Jesus, there will be some days that there will be rejoicing. And Lord, to realize in the good memories and even in the tough, that also we celebrate, Lord, a day of celebration that we know where she's at. And Lord, when I received that word and hung up the phone, all I can say is thank you, Jesus. She's home. And Lord, I thank you that you provided for us. And Lord, that we being all like Thomas, even though we question many times, and we have that Thomas mode of thinking, Lord. But Lord, I pray that as Thomas listened and we see the life of Thomas, how he supported you. And Lord Jesus, I pray that our hearts will be open to you. And Lord, that we're prepared to meet you because we do not know when it's going to be us that's going to leave this world. And Lord Jesus, I pray for this family. We love them and we thank them, Lord Jesus, for the love that they have for others and their friendship, Lord. And God, I pray that you will guide and lead us and direct us and direct this family in the days ahead. For Jesus Christ, we're not looking for a Savior to come back. Lord, you tell us to look for the King, the Lion of Judah. Oh, you're coming back as the Lion, as the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords. And Jesus, we're looking for your return. Soon and very soon, we're going to see the King. She's already with the King, but soon and very soon, we are going to see the King. In your precious name we pray, Lord Jesus Christ, our Savior, our Lord, and our soon coming King. Amen.
Girls, I am to me. I so much, we just missed out the back of the chapter. I decided to list that for the